Your NBC Sports Radio update starts now.
On the comeback trail, I'm Jeff Nathanson. On the scoreboard right now, it's the Giants leading the Eagles in the second quarter, but only by a margin of 14-10. It was 14-0 Giants, thanks to a couple of first quarter interceptions thrown by Carson Wentz that turned into points for the Giants. But the Eagles just got a rushing touchdown from Ryan Matthews to go with a field goal, and now it is 14-10 with 12:11 to go in the second quarter of play. Giants up by four. Odell Beckham Jr. has a touchdown in this game, a 26-yard catch and run from Eli Manning. Other scores, Dolphins lead the Jets 14-10. Jay Ajayi has a touchdown in this one for Miami. Justin Burris, a long run for a score for the Jets. That's in the second quarter. Ezekiel Elliott has scored for the Cowboys. They're leading the winless Cleveland Browns 14-3 to score in that one. That's also in the second quarter, 10 minutes to go until halftime. The Ravens lead the Steelers 7-0. That's in the second quarter. Joe Flacco to Mike Wallace for the score for Baltimore in that one. Ben Roethlisberger playing, but no points so far for the Steelers. Chiefs lead the Jaguars 7-0. That's in the second quarter. Lions and the Vikings have traded field goals 3-3 second quarter. Later, it's the Colts and the Packers. Indianapolis led by quarterback Andrew Luck. He the most sacked quarterback in the NFL this year. But he also is looking forward to playing against Aaron Rodgers.
I admire the way he plays the game of football very much. I don't know him very well. Met him a couple times, but you know, Scott obviously played with him. And speaks very highly of him. He's certainly one of the greats of this sort of generation. I know I enjoyed watching him when I was younger and in high school and through college. I certainly admire him very much.
That game kicks at 4:25 Eastern time. Saints and the 49ers this afternoon. Carlos Hyde is questionable for that one for San Fran. Jeff Nathanson, NBC Sports Radio.
Did you know that more than 100,000 people a day are downloading game apps? Mobile apps have become a normal part of everyday lives. Now there's a new exciting sports app that lets you play along with your favorite professional sports team in real time. With this fantastic app, you can predict the next play and even outguess your favorite team members. The more predictions you get correct, the more points you receive. Points can be exchanged for cool prizes, like your favorite jerseys, hats, airline tickets, sports tickets, even a new car. You can play this amazing sports app by yourself, with your friends, or even with a large group of fans from all over the world. This incredible sports app is called FireFan, and it's available right now. Check it out. Sign up today at www.freefirefanapp.com.
KCAA is having a baby, and we're in the labor room. Coming soon, before you know it, a brand new radio station, 102.3 FM, Riverside.
Hello, this is Deputy Sheriff Paul Schrader. When principal, leadership, experience matters, Mike Safey is your first choice for Redland City Council and first on the ballot. I've known Mike Safey for years. He's a business owner, a family man, and your first choice for Redland City Council.
When it comes to public or private service, Mike Safey has the experience in both worlds. Mike Safey's been a CEO for 20 years, owned a small business, employed dozens of people, and serves in key supervising roles for public safety and special investigations for the county. Mike's assisted in $80 million transportation and $110 million flood control budgets. Mike's a longtime community activist, contributes to our community of Redlands, and is the right choice on November 8th. Mike Safey is your first choice for Redlands City Council on the ballot. For more info, go to VoteMikeSafey.com. That's VoteMikeSafey.com.
I'm Mike Safey, and I approve this message.
Cheryl Brown, considered by many as an independent, common-sense assemblywoman. What assemblywoman Cheryl Brown really does is simply put our community first.
She believes in unity. Cheryl Brown believes that when we work together, we can do great things for our community.
Unlike Cheryl Brown's opponent, who falsely attacks her record and divides our community, Cheryl Brown has run a campaign focused on issues and unity in the Inland Empire.
Cheryl Brown has helped invest millions in our public schools, provide tax credits for our small businesses and raise the minimum wage, all while balancing the state budget.
Cheryl Brown is proudly supported by every mayor in the 47th Assembly District. The California Police Chiefs Association and the California Small Business Association all support Cheryl Brown. She has the support of hundreds of community leaders and organizations. Vote to re-elect Cheryl Brown to our State Assembly.
Paid for by Cheryl R. Brown for Assembly 2016.
KCAA.
I'm sick and tired of hearing the things from uptight, short-sighted, narrow-minded hypocrites.
Hey everyone, welcome to the Truth Only Show here on KCAA 1050 AM 106.5 FM. We are here today with a new show for you, new message, something great. And you can go and find out more about us and see our old videos on truthonlyshow.com. And also on there you can find our email, truthonlyshow@gmail.com. And you can send us a message of whatever you're thinking or whatever you would like to ask us. So that's truthonlyshow.com. And now, here's the host of the show, David Rodriguez.
Good morning, everyone. Great to be here with you today on another episode of our Truth Only Show. A show that's very important. It's very important for all of you listeners out there, because remember, somebody asked me a question one time. They said, how can you name your show the Truth Only Show? Well, it's because that's what we talk about here, is truth. And somebody suggested, well, how can you say it's truth when truth is relative? Well, in a sense, that is true. It is relative because everybody's believing their own, everybody that believes a different truth, that truth is relative to them. But there is such a thing as absolute truth. I mean, I'll give you a quick example of it right now. Absolute truth is, I'll give you an example, like 2 and 2 is 4. When did 2 and 2 become 4? I want you to think about it. And when will 2 and 2 not be 4? I think we can say that, agree that it'll be here forever. So that was, I'd throw that in just to mention that there is absolute truth. I mean, there are things that are just absolute for all of us. There are some things that we can never change. And those are absolute true things that we're believing. We can change. We can believe change our beliefs. So those are what I could call relative truths. But anyways, getting back to what we're doing, I want to welcome you all here, and I want to give thanks to the people that make this show possible. Our engineer, Mr. Joe Pagano, and our webmaster, Mr. Joel Strauser. And my co-host and producer, Michael. And today we're going to have somebody that's going to join in with us today on the discussion. He's a great man, very influential in my life, Mr. Bill McLeod. He's going to be join us a little bit later after we go on break. But just real quick, what we teach here is exactly what I talked about, truth. And we try to stick to the truth. And not opinions, because, you know, there are many, many shows out there that people are giving their opinions. And a lot of those are the most popular shows where people call in and everybody's giving an opinion, which is fine. It's okay. But, you know, on our show, what we deal with, we try to deal with the truth, something that you can do, something that you can take with you and use in your life. To make yourself a better life, something that will improve the situations in your life, that will make your life a little bit easier, little less stress, a little less worry, and maybe get a little more abundance to your life. And that is all. That all comes about by understanding who you are, the truth about yourself. So that's what we tend to try to stick with that right now. And I know that there are thousands of shows out there that are teaching you, talking about fighting against this cause and fighting against that, fighting against this, which is okay. But there are less shows like this where we actually give you things that can change your own personal life. improve your own life. That's what I think maybe you need to think about. Is it important for me to learn about myself and how to improve my own situation? That's just, you know, something to think about. Today my topic is, I'm going to talk a little bit about the effects of false teachings, okay? Because I believe there's a lot of false teachings out there. And in this day and age, I think it's becoming pretty obvious that there are some false teachings going around, even in this country. I mean, I see it all around the world, but in this country, things that really can affect our lives, and people are being influenced by things that maybe they never thought about it. But I mean, for example, there are millions of people supporting right now a person who really stands for everything opposite of what they are being taught and what we are all have been learning. We've been learning to have respect for each other. We're learning that we should love each other, that there should be kindness, that we should be helpful, that we should help the least among us. And yet right now there are millions of people supporting a person that is totally opposite, totally contrary to all that. So now how does that come about, and why did it come about? I mean, that we can actually support, and I'm talking about religious organizations. That, you know, what is it that are we supposed to be believing in? What are we really supposed to be standing for? Should we be standing for truth and goodness and respect? Or does that matter? Are we just throwing that out the window or what? It doesn't matter. I just want you to think about, you know, maybe we're being taught some things that are false, and we've never really given them a whole lot of thought. Let's take, for example, some of our religious teachings. Have you ever thought maybe that there is something missing, something that we are not being told, something that that has just eluded us, that something that we can't grasp, we can't understand? And there's one thing I can tell you for a fact. I know this might sound as a surprise to you, and it might sound different. Maybe you have never heard this idea, never heard this concept. But let's take the Bible, for example. I know for a fact that if you don't have the idea, the concept of its true purpose, what it was written for, I think that book is going to be nothing but confusion. And I think that there's been such a poor job of describing what's in that book that many people, I'm sure there's many of you out there that are listening, just put that book aside and don't even want to bother opening it up, don't even want to bother looking at it, because it just seems too overwhelming, because it kind of doesn't make any sense. So we just put it away. We ignore it. We don't want anything to do with it. And so we just turn our backs to it. And what I know to be true is that is all because it has been taught improperly. We haven't really been taught the truth about what it really is. What is that book really about? What it's really about, I want you to listen carefully. The purpose and what that book was written for was to teach us a law. And that law is the law of involution and evolution. That's its purpose. I don't have enough time on a show, on one show, to explain that thoroughly, but I'm going to do the best I can just to give you an idea, and I will throw a few concepts at you that maybe you can begin to grasp and understand what it is that I'm trying to tell you about involution and evolution. Now, involution is, let's say it's an idea, okay? Let's call it an idea, okay? Whatever ideas that you think on your own, when you're by yourself, you have ideas that are running through your mind. Now, whatever types of ideas that are run through your mind the most, regardless of negative or positive, has nothing to do with it. All I'm trying to say is the ideas that run through your mind the most within yourself, when you're by yourself thinking about your life, whatever goes through your mind the most, those ideas will evolve. They will evolve to what is your life, what you are experiencing. That's why I say I'm not talking about negative or positive, good or bad. That's up to you to decide what types of thoughts run through your mind when you're alone. If you tend to think a lot of those thoughts are on the negative side, and you're experiencing those things, it is because of involution and evolution. You're thinking it, you're dwelling it, and the idea, the concept will evolve. It's actually very simple. The book that I said, the Bible is trying to teach us involution and evolution. That's its purpose. That's what it was written for. I will give you some examples to back up what I'm trying to say. It says in there, if you had the faith the size of a mustard seed, you could move mountains. So let me see if I can explain that a little simpler. What it is saying about your thoughts, in other words, what I was just talking about, when you spend time thinking on your own about your life, if your thoughts are that you can do something, that you could become something, which there are many people that do. People believe they can become a great surgeon, a great heart specialist, a great musician. There are people that think that way. Those are the types of ideas they're running through their mind, and those ideas evolve. And they become, at to whatever level they can believe, they can become at whatever level they believe they can become. In other words, they can believe, and there are no limits. Remember, everything is infinite. Whatever the most advanced technologies that there are, even, let's say, take the heart, for example. The most evolved technologies that exist right now, there is still more. There is still more to learn and more to discover. It is infinite. Okay? So if you have a little bit of faith and you begin to believe in your thoughts that they will evolve, you just need a little bit of faith. Stick to a certain idea, certain concepts, and through law, they will evolve. Now, you've heard this before. With faith, you can do greater works than I. What does that mean? With faith now, if you can really believe that there are no limits to this process of involution and evolution, there is nothing, there isn't anything that will be hidden to you. It's right in that book, the Bible. It says there is nothing that will be hidden from you. In other words, discoveries are infinite. Ideas are infinite, and you will continue to discover more and more and more. There are no limits to what you can discover because your idea, will continue to evolve as long as you remain focused on that concept. And I'm going back again to what I said earlier. Earlier I said it's got nothing to do with negative or positive. Has got nothing to do with negative or positive. Because you can take your negative ideas and continue to dwell on them and continue to spiral downhill with your life. You can continue to spiral downhill with that idea, because remember, involution, that's what you're thinking, that's what you're dwelling on. Involution, evolution, it will evolve. It will evolve and take you in a downward spiral, and it will take you all the ways till you can get so depressed that we know what happens to people when they get totally depressed. They start, hurting themselves. That's how bad it gets. Even they take their own lives. Now, I'm going to give you some more scripture. It says, the tongue has the power of life and death. The tongue is not, remember, that book is not a physical book, and it's not telling you literally. It's just teaching you this concept of involution and evolution. In other words, what you're talking, and we've already discussed this before on the show, words are thoughts first. So it's talking about your thought world, your mental world. Your mental world is your involution, the ideas that you think, they will evolve. Even to the point of what you say and think about yourself, the tongue has the power of life and death. Now the life, that's, we can say, the death part. In other words, it will take you just in a dark, dark place in your life. But your words can give life. They can create life experiences. In other words, your words of joy, like I started out with, maybe we're being taught things. We're supposed to be following the teachings, which is supposed to be love and goodness and being helpful and having joy and peace and helping the least among us. That's what we're being taught. That's what that book is telling us, because that's what will bring you life. It will bring you more life. More love brings more life to your life. So the tongue has the power of life and death through involution and evolution. That's what the book is teaching. Now, it said right in the beginning, it says that God, it says here, it says, let there be light. Remember when in Genesis, when it's talking about that everything was made in 7 days, it's not a literal thing that it's talking about. It's talking about thought, our mental world. Let there be light. Let there be firmament. Let there be life. The fish, the animals. And that idea, that invisible idea, it starts mentioning that there was nothing before that. Nothing existed before that until this mental idea, this mental concept brought it into life. It brought it into life. The creator of everything brought it into life. And it's only, the only thing we can associate with the spirit that is talking about is thought. That's all we can associate with spirit is thought. And it's telling us that this thought process or spirit thought or spoke these things into existence because nothing existed before. Well, it is the same thing that an individual with his own life, with his thought world speaks things into existence. And again, we're not referring to negative or positive, because it doesn't, what I'm trying to say is, it doesn't matter if you're thinking negative or positive. That is the ideas that you are bringing in, and those are the concepts that will evolve. So it's talking about that you can also speak your life into existence. That's why it says you are made in the image and likeness of God, because your mental world operates the same way as that book is telling you, that the spirit of the creator of everything spoke everything into existence. It didn't exist before, and then it exists now. Well, the ideas and concepts, your new ideas, don't exist in your life now, but when you begin to think them, in other words, involution, they evolve into your life experiences now. Ideas like becoming a heart specialist, ideas like becoming a brain surgeon, your idea or your involution begins to evolve. The idea begins to evolve. In other words, everything comes through evolution. And you are being taught not to even believe in evolution. And that book was written with the idea to teach us involution and evolution, because that is everything in life. That is everything to do with your thought world, your mental world. Your mental ideas, your mental concepts evolve into what you are living right now, into what you are experiencing right now. That's why I say we teach the truth on this show. No false concepts, no false ideas. So when you understand what we're trying to teach, hopefully you will grasp this idea of involution and evolution and begin to think your life the way you want it into existence. Think your life, think what you would like to experience, make it your focus, give it all your attention every day. And it will evolve, and one day you will be experiencing exactly what you want, and maybe even something greater than you would love to experience. Remember, you have to think about if you've been experiencing some false teachings, or are you ready to learn the truth about who you truly are? Don't go away. We'll be right back after a short break, and we're going to have a discussion, and we have our guest with us today, Mr. Bill McLeod. He will be joining us in a few moments. And when I go away, I know my heart can stay with my love. It's understood. It's in the hand.
Still find something there with my love. It's understood. It's everywhere with my love. My love, does it good? Oh, 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 oh.
Don't ever ask me why I never say goodbye to my love. It's understood, it's everywhere with my love.
Welcome back. That song's called My Love by Paul McCartney and Wings. So we're here talking about it. What was the name of your talk today? Did you have a title?
Yeah, The Effects of False Teachings.
Okay, False Teachings. Before we get into that, why don't you introduce our guest?
Today I want to introduce our guest, special guest today. Mr. Bill McLeod, he's also has his own radio show, and we're going to give you some information on it, but his name, Mr. Bill McLeod. Bill, my friend, thank you very much for being here. It's really an honor to have you here with us on the show. I really appreciate it.
Well, I'm glad to be
Joe, can you hear this?
There we go.
Okay, all right. I'm glad to be here myself. So, once again, it's my pleasure. I always love to be with you.
Yeah, we are. Anytime, Joe, Bill, whenever, like I said, you want to pop in on our show, it's great to have you.
We've
talked about that many times and haven't been able to get you to come out enough.
Usually on Sundays, I play golf.
I
have a bunch of buddies. We all get together on Sundays. I play golf, and it's the only time I have to, be with them and all. So I started doing that. I just started to learn how to play golf.
Oh, really?
Just recently.
Are you getting good at it now, or what?
I've been doing it for a year, and I feel pretty comfortable doing it.
Good.
I can hit the ball pretty good.
Never tried it, Bill.
Yeah, right. Well, it's sort of like what you're teaching here. We all go through life, and sometimes our life is a mess, and we have no idea how to get it corrected. We go through all the procedures that everyone else is following, but those are not the patterns you want. You come out basically the same way. So you need something very good and something very different. And this show, The Truth Only, and when you were explaining about why you call it The Truth Only, because the truth is necessary. It's very important. We're having a lot of things going on television now with the election and all. And it's the only office in the world, the highest office in this country, that you have to lie to get into. So it's sort of like that in our society. And I thought my granddaughter, you made me think about my granddaughter. She just graduated from high school. She's got a high school diploma. So she takes the high school diploma around, and she says, I'm going to get a job. So she found out that the high school diploma is not worth much. She spent 12 years doing it. So there's another form of, I guess, maybe some kind of deception. What is the idea of this, of going to school for 12 years, and when you get out,
you need more.
You need more than that.
You need more, right?
It's just different. It's just different now.
It's unbelievable. Yeah. So we are being taught a lot of deception in the society. Maybe it was for some reason, but I think.
Bill, still, we still need to learn the basics, right?
Right.
We need to learn the basics.
We need to learn the truth if we plan to be free.
As we live our lives, we need some truth, because then we start believing a lot of false things, like what you just mentioned. You see it this way, that we got to lie to become the most powerful person earth. But you got to lie, but you got to get all the people to believe your lies.
And some people are good at that.
So there's something, maybe something wrong with what we're thinking. If we can allow somebody to be lying to us, and we'll follow them. So there's something wrong with what we've been learning.
Yeah.
There's something wrong with what we've learned.
Yeah, we have. It's very unfortunate in life, and I was telling my granddaughter, I said, life is sort of like this. Yesterday I told you a lie, but today I'm telling you the truth. So it's confusion after confusion after confusion. And a show like yours is very, very, very important for anyone. If people, if you listen to the show, it's a very important message. It helps you to develop your life where you want to go. Because right now, most people will blame this and blame that and blame this and blame that and never take the proper steps to help themselves be better. And it's only a show like this that will ever give them an even an indication or inclination that there's something else.
So what were the false teachings that you were that you had in mind when you gave your talk or when you came up with your talk?
Well, the false teachings is that, you know, I don't like to put people in groups or categories, but I mean, sometimes, you know, you almost can't avoid it. You can't, you know, you just can't avoid it. Like right now, there's a great, a big movement in the religion, religious organizations right now that are supporting someone that's totally contradictory to what they're being taught, what they're being told. So there's something wrong with what they're being told. I mean, they're supporting a person that that does the total opposite of what we should be learning: more love, more peace, more understanding, more, and the person is teaching the hatred and violence and teaching all these, talking about all these things. But yet there's millions of people that are supporting that, you know, so something's wrong
talking
with
about hypocrisy.
Well, yeah, the hypocrisy right now. I mean, it's, I think it's being exposed. It's, I think what it's going to do is going to take make people take a look at themselves, look at where they are, what they belong to. People should take a look at themselves once in a while. What is it I'm following? Who am I following?
Right.
You know.
Yeah. So we, like, I don't know. I guess when you say truth only show, a person will think about how. What makes you think you have the truth on it?
Well, here I'll give you an example for. I mean, as I started to say before, there is absolute truth. There's relative truth. Relative goes back again to what I said earlier. One person believes one thing, another person believes something else, and everybody's believing something different. All that's relative truth. What you believe is relative truth. There are certain truths that are absolute. I mean, there's an electrical cord, bare electrical wire there. It doesn't matter what your beliefs are, what your faith is, what color your skin is, what nationality you are. Whoever grabs a hold of that wire is going to get burned and probably killed when you grab that wire right there. And I don't care where you are, where you were born, how old you are, whoever grabs it is going to get killed. That's an absolute truth.
Truth, right. Yeah.
Now, there's a big difference between the relative, because that has nothing to do with what you believe in. It has not a thing to do with it. It's just truth. If I take one religious group, if I take a Muslim, a Christian, a Jewish, a Buddhist, and we go out and stand out in the middle of the desert with no water, it's just a matter of time. All of us are going to drop dead. It doesn't matter what we believe or what we think or anything. That's another absolute truth.
Right.
So that is what we do on this show. We talk about absolute truth. We don't talk about relative truth. It's just absolute. That's truth. The difference.
That's what we teach, yeah.
That's what we teach here, absolute truth.
So then you talking about the effects of it. So what are the effects of, you know, these?
The effects of relative truths and relative ideas that we're believing, many times our beliefs, we can be led around by other people that have a little stronger idea. We can be led around. Absolute truth, now what it really can do for your life, that's what this show is all about. Absolute truth, when you begin to understand it, you can look at life and eventually you will eliminate all the obstacles that are holding you back from becoming whatever it is that you want to become. You will remove the obstacles in your mind and you will begin to see clearly the road ahead of yourself and to be what you would like to be and have the kind of life that you would like to experience. That's what this show is about, to help you remove the obstacles that are there. And some of these obstacles are subconscious. But this show will help you remove the subconscious obstacles that you don't even realize that are stopping you from moving ahead and creating the life that you would love to live.
What were some of those obstacles in your guys' lives that you realized after you were able to conquer them, I guess?
You, Bill, you want to answer that?
Yeah.
Some of the obstacles that you had.
Well, my first one was I was raised by my grandmother, and she was a very strong Baptist person. And so she implanted in our minds, it was my brothers and sisters, myself, that that there was a power outside of us that was making our life what it was. So it was like we were destined to be this, or we were destined to be that. You couldn't do this, you couldn't do that. And then we were also, I guess, came up with the idea that, well, we got to get, if we're going to get better than where we are, we got to get somebody else to lift us up to that point. And so that was a misconception. So when I came into this thought, I didn't realize that what I saw in my life, I had created myself.
Right.
So that was a truth that I had to learn and had to overcome, because I kept thinking, no, 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 it's not me. It's them over there somewhere else. And finally, I had to realize that. And then a couple of years ago, when you became my mantra and began to help me keep me on track, I began to see something else that you were teaching me, and that was think good all the time.
That's it.
And that little one little thing right there is what I did. And from that one little thing, I'm 86 years old. Mm-hmm. I've almost doubled my income, and I haven't filled out one application right for a job. So it, we know that it works. It is the truth. To me, it is the truth. And I think that's difficult for people to more or less get their arms around and say, I'm going to start thinking my life into where I want it to be. But if you think about the fact that you're created in God in your image and likeness, God is a creator, so are we.
We are creators. If I say to somebody that you are a creator, there is a creator of the universe, but your creator, it made you in its image and likeness. Why is that so difficult to understand? Your thoughts are creating your experience. You chose not to go to school, so now you are living the circumstances of not going to school. Another person chooses to go to school and chooses to go to school and take it to a high level. Now they're experiencing those kind of things
right.
in life. So you're creating your own experience.
Right.
So we are creators in that sense. We're given our own world, our own universe to create for ourselves. And that is for each and every one of us. We do not have to be victims of circumstance, because that's what you were talking about before.
Right, right, right.
You used to be a victim of circumstance.
That's right.
Because you were taught that.
Taught that, right. Mm-hmm.
Right.
So, okay. That's the cycle that a lot of people are in, right?
Many, many people.
And then you got to the part of your talk where you're talking about what really is going to change your life, right? What really is going to, as this is how your mind really works, and that was the involution and evolution part, right?
Right.
First off, if you guys are looking up involution, you got to look up the philosophical definition of it, because if you look up the just type in involution definition, it comes up with medical terms and mathematical terms and stuff. But
you have to keep going.
In philosophy, it means exactly what you meant. Let me see. I had it looked up. What did you mean it?
Well, I gave the simplest way to understand it. In other words, I tried to just break it down and make it simple. It's an idea that you're thinking about. or a concept that you're thinking about. And as long as you continue to think it, it will evolve into something. It's going to continue to evolve if you keep thinking it.
So,
or your choice to think of a certain thing.
Here's the definition, or a definition for it. Involution refers to a situation in which a process or object is turned in upon itself. So I think the thought is turned in on itself and it keeps on.
An idea.
The idea, yeah.
A concept, right. And see, here's the most important thing that if you can learn anything from this show today is that book, the Bible, it was written with that intention to teach that law of involution and evolution. And if you go into that book with a different idea, it's going to be nothing but a total nightmare, a total nothing but confusion, which exists today for many, many people. But if you can go in there with that concept, it's going to open up to you to the most amazing book that you will ever read in all your life. If you go in there with knowing that it was written with that intention and that purpose.
So what are some of the things that you guys are working on right now? Because I'm assuming that you guys have a motivation, something that you're working towards right now that you're using this process for.
You, Bill?
Oh, well.
And that's a personal question, but.
Yeah, I'm working on a goal right now. I never, is the mic working?
I'm not sure.
I'm not sure something happened.
Is the mic working? Joe?
Well,
I think it's working. Everything.
There it is.
There it is. There you go.
Okay. You hear me now? Yeah.
So what are you working on?
I never really tell what I'm doing.
That's okay. Cool. I respect that. Me too.
but I do have, and everybody, this is a mistake that everyone has. They don't have a goal or dream except for New Year's. They come for New Year's, and the week afterward, they've forgotten it.
Yeah.
And I think everyone should begin to realize that by making a goal, involution and evolution means to me cause and effect.
Right. Yeah. Right.
It's like what I'm thinking inside and it's going to evolve. Everything you see came from somebody's mind.
Mm-hmm. Right.
Everything you see came from the mind.
Thought created everything.
So that's a truth.
Right. Mm-hmm. That's an absolute truth.
You can't argue with that. Right. Mm-hmm. So we know that. So I think that once you begin to use the principles, and like you said earlier, get rid of the stumbling blocks. You have to. You may need help, and that's what's so wonderful about this show.
We all need help.
Helping you to do that, and everybody should listen and pay attention and learn what it is. Mm-hmm. But I have another goal. A lot of goals. Let's see. My main goals. I had a set of goals that I've already accomplished. So now I'm on a new set.
That's good. Right.
Well, I'm not going to tell you what they are.
That's okay. But they're there. You're doing it.
They're there, right. They're really right.
Well, I think for myself, I think that learning and then knowing what I was put on this earth to do is taking me a long time in life, up to my later years now. I finally discovered why I'm here, what I'm here to do. Now, that's what this show is about. And it's not about teaching you to be it's not my purpose to teach you to be like me or to discover what I've discovered for myself. No, this show is about helping you discover what your purpose is here in life. Because when you learn the truth about yourself, you will discover one day what your purpose is. That's it. What your purpose is in life.
We went a little long, but we're going to take a really quick break and come right back.
We'll be right back.
Okay.
Oh, welcome back. That song's called Let Me Roll It by Paul McCartney and Wings once again. We're back here with Bill McLeod, and we are just discussing how to use our thoughts, right?
Right, basically.
So first off, what do you do, Bill, when you're working on something? You know, what does that mean? You know, when you have your goal, like what are you thinking, or how do you think about it, or what's your process?
Well, first, if I have something I want to do, I realize that I have to stay focused on it quite a bit. In our daily life, we are hit with all kinds of things. Mm-hmm. So we may learn about this teaching, the truth only, but a lot of time we don't practice it because we're so busy doing other things. So if it don't work, that's probably one of the reasons why, because we're just too busy to do it. So I spend time every day thinking about what I really desire and what I want. Mm-hmm. So, and I know if I spend more time putting that energy in it, I'm helping to create it. Right. I'm forming it. And that's where it comes from, your mind. Right. And I think you were going to talk about something that was very interesting.
Yeah, well, you mentioned that everything was made by thought, which is true. I mean, just anybody that's listening to me right now, look around you, look around in the room, and everything that you can see with your eyes was made by thought. It was a thought process that went to making it, to creating it. And it was a thought, it was an idea that, idea like we talked about involution and evolution. The idea evolved, and then now it's a physical thing that you can see. Everything came about that way. What does the Bible say? That's why I say it's teaching involution and evolution. It says right there so clearly, there was not anything made that was made without the Word. Everything that was made by the Word. And we've talked about that on this show before. What is a word? A word first is a thought. Before you can speak a word, you got to think it. So it is first a thought. So what that book is saying, that everything that exists was made by a thought. And I also want to mention, because you said something about school. Mm-hmm. School is great. I recommend everybody to go to school. The more you can, the better. But there you can learn also some great concepts that aren't being taught in the schools. I mean, shows like this, we're teaching you the truth about yourself to create the experiences in your life, which can enhance anything that you learn in school, make it much better.
Hmm. Your process, basically what you said is you dedicate time to it, just thinking about it, right?
Right. Dedicate time to it. Keep it on your mind. Mm-hmm. Focus. You know, you just focus on it. Mm-hmm. I don't think you need to beg for it to happen because you are creating. You don't beg. But I just think about it pleasantly, and I see myself doing or whatever it is pleasantly, and I let it go because I know I cannot do it, because if I knew how to do it, I'd be doing it already.
You would have done it already.
You would have done it already, right. So I let it go, and I leave it to the power that is in you, which is the creative power, and I let it go to work. And I don't. Sometimes after I feel that I've said it enough, I forget about it.
Yeah.
Hmm.
I don't even think about it anymore. I just know it's going to happen. And that's when I think about it, I always think about it. So it's on its way.
It's on its way.
It's on its way. Right.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. Just like when you're thinking problems, there's more on their way.
Yeah.
They're coming.
That's a simple way of manifesting whatever you want. It's maybe so simple that people may not even get it.
Yeah.
Right.
So, yeah. Sounds too good to be true.
Right? Yeah.
Well, we're coming near the end of the show. Why don't you try to wrap up what you have? What we talked about here today.
Well, what we talked about here is really trying to get people to think about some false teachings, because if you're being led by someone else, another person is leading you around, and you're becoming dependent on another person. You maybe need to question what it is that you're believing. Who are you following? Because as we talked about here, the creative power of the mind, you have it. You have the power to create the experiences that you're out there fighting for. So many people are out there fighting this cause or fighting that cause to create their life, or waiting for somebody else, or waiting for the government to make your life better. When all the power is within yourself, with the power of involution and evolution, you have that power to focus your attention on your life the way you would love to have it and let it evolve. And if anybody's teaching you to not to believe in evolution, I suggest you run away. Get away from them, because that is some false teaching. The Bible's purpose, and it was written to teach you the law of involution and evolution. Hmm. So that's basically the show today.
So, Bill, thank you for joining us.
Oh, and thank you. My pleasure being here. I love it.
Please come back whenever you can.
Yeah, right.
Thank you so much, Bill. And my friend, great to have you here with. I really appreciate
it. You have a show,
you
too. What is the website for your show?
My show is Let Grandpa Speak. You can go there on the internet. Let Boss
Just speak. Type that into Google. They'll find it. Yeah,
let grandpa speak. Go on there. We highly recommend it.
There we go.
We've got a great show.
Yeah.
And I have something to remind our listeners. If you suffer or know someone who suffers from symptoms related to a heart rhythm disturbance, if you have a fast, slow, or irregular heartbeat, symptoms which include palpitations, shortness of breath, fatigue, heart racing, dizziness, lightheadedness, fainting spells, if you want to cure or fix the problem, call or contact the brilliant Dr. Truong Duong. He's an electrophysiologist, and you can contact him at 877-773-8664. Remember, 877-773-8664.
And you can find us at truthonlyshow.com. And we will be glad to see you next week. So check us out next week. Thank you.
And remember, you're listening to the David Paul Band. I highly recommend you go to davidpaulmusic.com. Check out the calendar for a great night of entertainment. And we will see you next week.
You're listening to KCAA. Loma Linda, California. The best station in the nation.
Your NBC Sports Radio update starts now.
Busy day in the